Hello, my beautiful Sagittarius friends and everyone. Welcome. Thank you for stopping by. My name is Donna. This is Irish Donna Tarot. We're here for a new love reading. And also send me a comment as to where you're viewing the video from. I'm broadcasting from Chicago, and it's always so much fun to know where everyone is around the world, and I thank you. So let's look at this new love reading, Sagittarius. International travel, which is your house on the astrology wheel, is opening up again. So let's look and see what the opportunities are for you in love at this time. All right, so let's see what we have. Ace of Cups, new love. Oh, look at this. Oh my goodness, two hearts beating as one. We can't make this up. So you have someone coming in that's very worthy of your time and your energy. The Two of Cups, the Ace of Cups, we have you. You want the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth in terms of love. You may be attracting a Leo energy, somebody who's very strong, very fiery, somebody who is very reliable. You may have known this person. This is the infinity symbol, so you may have known this person in previous lives. You may really be someone that you might have known for a long time but didn't really think about them in terms of a romantic relationship. I can't even make this up. Look at this. Sagittarius, what is going on with you? The card of Twin Flame. The Naked Heart Tarot is the only deck that I have that has a number 22. We see the butterfly of transformation and these beautiful roses draping this heart. I am stunned. This is just an absolutely exquisite reading. So let's see what else is going on. Ten of Pentacles, a legacy, commitment, relationship, Virgo energy, working hard, two people who create a life for themselves that is happily ever after. It is a life of abundance, joy, happiness, and working hard to create security. You have the Three of Wands. Oh, that's like that. Your ship has arrived in the harbor. So I would say that you may know who this person could be. You might meet them in the near future. You may have met them already and you're just not really fully aware of this. Six of Coins, somebody who is willing to give to your relationship. Taurus energy, Aries energy. Lots of love here, my friends, lots of love, Leo energy. We have the energy of, until somebody is ready to throw down an anchor, you are not paying any attention to them. If a person doesn't show you, or a love interest doesn't show you that they're willing to anchor themselves in a relationship, you're like kissing them goodbye. You are not interested. It also looks as though somebody from the past has been trying to reach you and you are not having it. So I would say the past is the past and you're open for something that's new only. Hierophant energy, traditional relationship. That is a marriage card typically. It's also your belief system, what you value. You want something that can last forever. You're very clear about what you want here. Absolutely crystal clear. Four of Wands. The Twin Flame card again, 11-11, the bride and groom typically dancing under the garland at the wedding. Let's look and see what the wisdom of the oracle has to say for you at this time. Well, that is a stunning new love reading. All right, so let's see what we have here. We have building blocks. Well, that is a Ten of Coins energy. Certainly the building blocks, really building a foundation that is unshakable. We have higher power, a very strong spiritual connection aspect to your relationship. We have happy, happily ever after. Very interesting energy. It looks like you might be talking to two or three people at the most, but let's go ahead and clarify these cards. The truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth. You want somebody who knows how to communicate and who is open to talking. So let's see what we have in this energy for you, Sagittarius. Eight of Cups. You've walked away from somebody who was less than honest. You've left it in the past. You know, you won't put up with it anymore. You know what you want. You're going towards your happiness. And the Eight of Cups is always headed towards the Ten of Cups. So We have single, ready to mingle, looking good, highly desirable Virgo energy. Everybody wants the Nine of Pentacles. That is pre-Empress energy. You are looking good. You are very attractive to many people. And, you know, you have a lot of options here. The Two of Cups. Oh, my gosh. Somebody's coming in. You have a strong Cancerian energy here in the reading. Somebody who's very loving. Somebody who can open their heart, open their emotions. Two hearts beating as one. Why is a strength card here for you, Sag? Let's see. All right. So, Sagittarius, this is actually your energy. You are going to play the field until you find your person, until you feel as though somebody is stable, somebody who, you know, is coming in that's willing to go the distance. You're just going to have some fun. You're not going to worry about anything. You're going to let life unfold. You're going to be open. But inside, you may look like you're just out having fun, but you are in a deep search for the truth. The whole truth, you know what you want, Virgo energy, you are making plans for the future, you know what you want, Monday through Sunday in a love relationship, you may be attracting a Virgo, Sun, Moon, Rising, or Venus. We have the energy of the King of Wands, okay? Very sexy, very fiery, very charming, but when we get the King of Wands, that's Leo energy twice here. The Strength card. This is a person who has a lot of pride, a lot of dignity, but they know how to build. They're very spiritual. They know how to be happy. They know how to laugh. They know how to make you laugh, Sagittarius. Not that you need a lot of help in that department, because you tend to be pretty jovial. You tend to be adventurous. So this is very much a kindred spirit for you. So what else do we have for this energy? We have the Strength card again. I can't make this up. It looks like many of you may have another fire sign in your energy field or somebody that embodies those characteristics. The twin flame card shows that it's hard for you to believe in a twin flame. That's you feeling very insecure. Is this my twin flame? Isn't it my twin flame? Are twin flames really real? I don't really know. I feel a little underwater. I feel fearful. I've been hurt in the past by what I thought was a twin flame, is what I'm channeling for you. But you have come through the worst of it, Scorpio energy twice. You have come through a transformation. For some of you may have had a twin flame in which you ended a relationship because you felt uncertain, but I see that no matter what status you are, have been with a twin flame in the past, you are ready to come into union. And that's what I have. This is a Scorpio King, somebody who's been in the perfect storm and survived, is smooth sailing, somebody who's very self-possessed, very dedicated, very fixed in their energy, somebody who says, you know, if they're going to show up on Friday at 5 o'clock, they are there at 4:59. Very reliable energy, very calm, very loving and nurturing. The Star card. Oh, that means hopes and dreams for love coming true. You are interested only in a spiritual warrior, and you're getting possibly an Aquarius. Could be a Virgo, somebody with a combination of that in their chart. The Star card, look at that, wishing upon a star and actually reaching that outcome. This is one of the most powerful cards in the deck for love. You know, you have really been wishing upon a star. You've been praying. You've been meditating for your happiness with somebody with whom to build, and you have found it at this time. In the near future, that's what I see for you. The Three of Wands, you have your eye on somebody that you're not telling, you feel could be the person that you would choose. You're keeping this to yourself. You're kind of sneaking around, watching the social media, you know, being very attentive, to see if they share your values. We have, again, the Ten of Coins. The Ten of Coins, the same card as it's depicted here in the Light Seer's Tarot. We see this incredible family. Everybody pulls together, the wife, the husband, you know, however that resonates, can be any combination of things, but it shows that you're both dedicated to working hard. You have great loyalty. You love to be together with a lot of laughter. This coin is a passionate dedication to family, friends, and all that you value, all that you want in your life, coming into alignment with it. Six of Coins energy is both of you being willing to give to one another, and it is only a matter of time. Sag, there you are in your reading. You have, it's time, your time. It's, you know, the Wheel of Fortune is upright. You're in this energy of, you know, really knowing, and intellectually, you did lock your heart in a cage because you don't want to make an only emotional decision, but you are very level-headed, truth, whole truth, nothing but the truth. You are looking for this person who's willing to commit. If they aren't willing to commit, that's a seventh house of marriage, is Libra energy. You are just, you know, you don't care. Take a hike, go somewhere else. I'm really, you know, that's how you feel, is very much the energy of you want to be able to develop mastery with somebody. You want to get to know somebody really well before you have your happily ever after. That is Pisces energy. That's the Ten of Cups energy. It's the energy of finding your person, and it's just pure joy. When I get the Ten of Cups and the Ten of Coins and the Strength card and the Star card, that is unbelievably almost life-altering in terms of your happiness, Scorpio energy. So you have had an ending with somebody from the past. It looks like there is someone who's going to try to come back. I don't think you're going to take them back with the Death card or the Two of Swords. I feel as though they will reach out to you, you know, on the web or through social media. And it, although it's a beautiful energy, you know, I get the Justice card here. You may give them a chance because we have the Libra Queen. But let's see what else. Would you give this person a chance from the past? Well, if they tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth, some of you will. For others, this, oh, there we go. Ace of Wands, a new passionate beginning in a love relationship. So this will be for some of you. Some of you will choose a Scorpio. Some of you will choose an Aquarius. But it does show that you will at least hear this person out and see what they have to say. But it does look as though, ooh, the King of Pentacles energy. So this person may prove worthy for some of you. You may be dealing with a Taurus. You may choose a Taurus. So take it as it resonates. General readings are like a buffet table. You only take what belongs to you. So for some of you, you left a marriage behind, and it looks as though you just packed it in. It looks for many of you, you left something that was very unsatisfying, very burdensome. You want someone with whom you can build. Five of Swords, you did have somebody in the past that you left behind that played mind games. Again, I don't see you doing it. Hanged Man, you're trying to figure out why they did it. That is a spiritual card, but you want somebody with whom you can be victorious. I get, again, you want somebody who's proud of you, who's very forthright. You want someone who is going to stand by your side. Sagittarius, there you are in the reading. So there are some of you who will get back together with someone else from the past, but many of you are willing to just allow that tower to fall. So again, it'll be different for everyone. It can be rebuilding the tower with somebody from the past, or somebody brand new with whom you really click. This is new love, and I think that's going to be most of you. The Four of Wands energy. Okay, it's too good to believe. You're so worried. Sagittarius, what are you afraid of here? It's almost too good to be true. It's how I'm reading this. The energy that I'm getting is you're like, no, this can't be true. I've never had good luck like this before. Even though I rule the Wheel of Fortune, I'm just not sure I believe that this could happen to me. Eight of Swords is self-imposed restriction. It's, you know, turning a blind eye right now to what the possibilities are to keep yourself safe. But you're all up in your head. It's Gemini energy. Let's see what's going on with that. You do want somebody who's going to give equally in a partnership. And if they don't, you're not having it. You will ignore them. You will release them. But you are releasing a lot of fears at this time. As you enter twin flame territory, we have the Three of Cups, the Ace of Cups, the Two of Cups. Lots, so much love here. You really do want to marry your twin flame. You are invested in things that work out. You are going to make the choice for happiness. And you want somebody with whom you can really collaborate, work with as a team. But you are releasing anybody or anything that doesn't really show you integrity and honesty and building blocks for the future. It looks like you're going to manifest a very beautiful love relationship. Sagittarius, that is what I have for you. Thank you so much for joining you. Joining you. That's funny. Anyway, sending you love from Chicago. Hope to see you soon again in another video. Bye-bye.